What's up, guys? It's me, Eric B, and welcome back to the channel. And I have a dilemma. I need to talk. Let's chat for a minute. So, as y'all know, I recently just got this FZ10, and now I have the bug. Why? Because I've been looking at Yamaha R6s. So ever since I did a first ride on my boy Marcus's R6, I'm sold on that thing, dude. I want one so bad. I don't know why. Well, I do know why. There's a few reasons why I want the R6, and some of you are probably like, okay, Eric, you just got the FZ, and it's a 600. Like, you went from a Gixxer 600 to a Gixxer 1000, and then you still have a 1000, you know, going with the naked bike version of it. Why would you want an R6? Man, this guy changes out bikes more than he changes his underwear. Also, some of you may be thinking, well, why don't you just keep the FZ and also get the R6 and add it to the collection? Well, it's not that easy. Whatever you do, don't get married. Just kidding. You can get married. I'm just kidding. But no, I just got a lot of other things going on right now, and I just can't have multiple bikes. And it would be nice to have at least two bikes. You know what I'm saying? You got guys that have, you know, 4, 5, 6, 7 bikes. But nope, not right now, not for me. So it's just gonna be one or none. And the reasons why I want an R6 is, number one, for the track. R6 is known to be an awesome track bike. I do want to start doing track days. I actually wanna start doing not just, you know, one track day a year or something like that. I actually want to start getting into it, and that would be the perfect bike to do it with. Now, I know you can track the FZ, and people do it all the time, but I feel that that bike would be a little bit better for, you know, learning and becoming better on the track, just because it's not only is it lighter, but it doesn't have all the power either, you know, down low or whatever. I know it's a screamer up top. So I just feel like you could work more on like handling, holding lines, you know, braking later, stuff like that, instead of trying to use the power to your advantage. I don't know, that's just me. For those of you that they're avid track goers, just give me some advice down in the comments. Let me know what you think. Man, and do they look so good, man. Those R6s, the fourth generation, like, they just, that would be the one that I would get if I was to get one, you know, 2017 plus. Man, they just, oh my god, it looks so good. The other thing is, now that they are being discontinued, they're going to be harder to find, you know, as the years go on. You can still find them right now, but I'm just, you know, I really want one, and I'm afraid that I'm not going to be able to get what I want if I wait too much longer, and I want a white one. I think those ones look gorgeous, and yeah, that's just one of the other reasons as well, and that's kind of like my logic of it, because I know I can find an FZ or an MT10 anytime, anywhere I want to. You know what I'm saying? I feel if I can only have one bike, a lot of people would say the MT would be the way to go if you could only have one bike, because you kind of get the best of everything. You know, you get the comfort, you get the power, you get a lot of stuff in this bike. The R6, you can make it work, man. People have sport bikes and make it work all the time. They commute on them and everything. It's not much of a commuter bike. And here's the thing too, I really don't commute on my bike anyway, even with the FZ. I'll take it out, you know, ride it back and forth to work every now and again, and then go out and have some fun with the boys, but it's not a bike that I'm gonna just be traveling on, you know? So the main purpose is it'll be my track bike, and then it'll be my bike that I go out and have some fun with. And then, you know, I'll have another sport bike back on the channel for you guys, because I know a lot of people really like the sport bike content that I put out. And then I think later on, I'll circle back to another naked bike or something like that. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know. What do you guys think? If I only have one bike right now, should I hang on to the FZ, or should I just go on ahead and get an R6 That way, you know, I can start doing some track days with that. Have a sport bike on the channel for you guys, start doing some mods and stuff like that to it. Decisions. The thing has power, man. It's ridiculous. It gets on it quick. I don't know, guys. What do you think? Would I be making a mistake getting rid of the FZ for an R6? Is that a cop? I don't know if that's a cop. That's what this thing is awesome for. So easy to do it. But yeah, guys, just a quick video on that. Just wanted to kind of see what you guys think about it. Leave me a comment down below, you know, if you have an R6 or if you have a naked bike of some sort, and you're even thinking about, you know, going in that direction. All right, you guys stay safe out there, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.